Let's go for some, we're gonna go high knees. So marching forward, high knee, pull that leg, but keep your body straight, right? Don't lean back, just pull that leg up a little bit more, but keeping that neutral spine. And then we can simply walk back, back pedal, up to you on this one. Do this for a good minute. So mentioned last night that for this workout, you're gonna need a couple dumbbells, hopefully like medium size weight. For myself, I'm gonna be working with some 35s. Hopefully most of you have at least, I would say, some 15s to 20s for it to be nicely challenging today. Next up, you guys, let's go for some alternate lateral lunges. So step one way, bring your butt back, come to the center, and go the other way. So we're going between those two positions. Really getting the sides of the glutes to warm up, and then we're gonna do some lateral shuffles to get your heart rate up. The movements that are on that board are some classics right here today. Not too many crazy compound moves. They are compound moves, but they're not combo moves. They'll still make you work a lot since we got the weights in hand. Let's take a break from the lunges and let's go for the shuffles now, you guys. So shuffle to one side, touch the floor, shuffle back to the other side. Remember, you can pull your foot or you can push by extending the leg. And this kind of a little jump to the side. So two different types of shuffles here. Then still breathe through the nose, but let's get that heart rate to go up by putting a little bit more speed. Now you guys, we're moving from that shuffle to a back pedal and a little run forward. Come low, touch the floor and back pedal. Touch the floor, come forward. So it's still putting some speed. Hopefully you don't not knocking anything down in your house, apartment. Hopefully no dogs in between your feet right now. Awesome. And we're slowing it down again. Let's go for some RDL walks, single leg RDL walk. So step, kick one leg back, go deep into that RDL, squeeze the glutes, take a step with the opposite foot. Same thing right here. You can even reach for the floor if you want and touch it. Once you're at the end, either do the same thing walking back or walk back to starting position and start over again. Try to keep that back flat, core engagement, big core engagement here. Got about a minute to go here, and then we'll go through the board, and then you have 30 minutes to do as much work as you can. One more set of RDL walks and I'm gonna get us finishing with some squat jacks. Haven't really got the upper body going too much, so actually we'll do some jumping jacks. So let's finish up with that so we get the arms moving a little bit too. We're gonna go for some jumping jacks, you guys. Okay, so feet out, hands overhead. Find a pace that you can maintain here for 30 seconds or just about. Thank you. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead, take a break. Let me just make sure you're still connected with me and we're gonna go over this board. All right, awesome. So, the way I plan today, like I said, you're gonna need those two dumbbells right here. Otherwise, it's just not gonna be the same. So the way I've programmed it is, I'm using a weight that for some of the exercises, once we get to 15 or 20 reps, I know I'm gonna have to take a break and break it down into two or three sets, okay, because of the volume. So hopefully you have some weights that are gonna force you to break down, let's say, the shoulder press. I'm not gonna do 20 reps with 35s in a row, especially after all the work that we're doing, right? So if you know that all the exercises that we're gonna go through on the board you can do in one setting with the weights you have, what I'm gonna challenge you to do instead is to slow down your movements. And if you do have the heavier weights, you're not gonna slow it down too much because otherwise it's gonna be really challenging. So this is how to go about it today. Now, let's go over the movements. A Romanian deadlift, you guys. Two dumbbells in hand, okay? We're gonna bring your hips back, keep that core engagement and shoulder blades peeled back. This is as deep as I need to go in the movement. You're gonna feel in your hamstrings and you're gonna pull here back up, squeeze your glutes at the top, okay? So that's gonna be your first move over here. Again, the pace is different. If you have really light weights, you can go a little bit slower. And if your weights are really somewhat heavy, regular tempo, one down, one up. Number two is gonna be the goblet squat. So you only need one of those two dumbbells here. At your chest, core engage, feet about shoulder width apart, and we're dropping down as deep as you can in that squat, and then obviously back to that starting position. Keeping those heel flat on the floor, those knee in line with your toes when you're squatting. So that's gonna be your goblet. Then we got your hip hinge low row. So again, you're gonna even use two dumbbells here, and it's often during the upper body movements that you're probably gonna need to break up the sets. Your forearms are probably gonna get tired from holding dumbbells a lot throughout this workout. So it's totally fine if you're taking breaks. Now, for the low row, same position as the RDL, hip hinge. Now hold that bottom position and pull those weights up. Elbows stay by your side when you're doing that one. Head is in line with your spine. So very important on everything we're doing today, especially since we're doing a lot of reps, you wanna make sure you got good positions on what you do today. Number four, we're gonna get to the floor and we're gonna hold a bridge position while doing a chest press. So iso bridge, chest press. Feet flat on the floor, squeezing the glutes at the top, and then elbows drops by your side for that chest press, right? So you really wanna keep the glutes tight the whole time and the elbows going out as you press. Your option is to keep your elbows by your side. Move into number, by the way, I've taken a picture of that and put it in my story if you needed to take a screenshot of that. Then we're moving to seated shoulder presses. So actually, I didn't mention it. Today you're gonna need a chair. So hopefully you have a chair with you for that one. You can also do it standing, but at the end we have some tricep dips, so you're gonna need that chair. So seated position, bringing the dumbbells here up to shoulder level and pressing overhead. Elbows out to the side, bottom position, and then overhead. If you can't go overhead, you're gonna be doing an upright row instead. So that's number five, that's a seated shoulder press. Six and seven, no weights needed. We're gonna do some abs. So first off, leg raises. Press your lower back down on the floor, bring those feet up towards the ceiling. Always keeping that lower back against the floor. Right after you're done with this one, feet are gonna come flat to the floor and you're gonna go all the way to a sit-up. And if you can't come all the way up to a sit-up, just do a bodyweight crunch instead. So, leg raise, sit-ups are back to back. Number eight, and we're getting close, you guys, so stay with me. Number eight, we're doing a pullover. You can do it from the floor or, like me, you can use the chair to do your pullover. It's just gonna take you a second to get set up here, but you're gonna want your back at the top of that chair, and from here, arms fully extended, that weight's gonna go all the way overhead and then back to that starting position above your chest right here. So always arms fully extended when you're doing that pullover. So no real option for this one, but you can do it from the floor as well. Number 9, you guys, we're getting there. Plank, low row, okay? Plank position, holding the dumbbells, and then you're gonna row 5 times total. So my first set, it's gonna be 3 on one arm, 2 on the other, keeping that elbows by my set, rowing that weight back to the floor and alternating. And as you can see, I'm keeping my feet nice and wide to stay balanced so I'm not rotating my body. The goal is for the abs to do a lot of work as well. Number 10, more abs. You're using one of the dumbbells here, and it's a standing lateral flexion. So you're standing up tall, bending to the side, and squeeze back up. Again, bending to the side and squeezing back up. For this one, you guys, we're gonna do 5 on each side on your first set. 10 on each side, 15, and then 20 on each side for the lateral flexion. So very simple, just a little bit of a bend, and then come back to that starting position. Again, using the same weights you've used since the start. Last 2, you guys, biceps and triceps, nice and easy. We're going bicep curl, standing up tall, and twist at the wrist at the top, okay? So again, 20 reps, might have to break it up into 2-3 sets at the end. And finally, last exercise, using that chair, you're doing a triceps dip. So you're gonna dip your hips towards the floor, hands at the extremity of that chair. If you cannot do that, you can always use that dumbbell and go overhead triceps extension. I hope you're still with me here. I know it was a lot of information. I'm gonna try and get my first round done at a okay pace, not too fast, so you can keep up just in case you're not sure what the exercise is. All right, fantastic. Thanks for your patience. So by the way, if it's your first time, we're doing 1 through 12 for 5 reps. Then you start over, you do for 10 reps. Start over, do everything at 15 reps. And then start over and do everything at 20 reps. If you get to finish everything at 20, you've done 600 reps and you've completed the challenge. I'm giving you 30 minutes to do so. I'm gonna count it down and get started myself. Here we go, you guys. In 3, 2, 1, let's do it. RDLs to get it kicked off. 30 minutes. Then that goblet squat, just one dumbbell at that chest. Breathe as you go down. Really keeping that core engagement when I'm going down with this one. I'm at number 3 with the low row. Always hip hinging in first, pulling the shoulder blades back. After the row, we got the press on our backs. The first set feels light because it's only 5 reps, but as we get to 10, 15, and 20, it's gonna be a different ball game. I'm going to number 5, seated shoulder presses. Six and seven are nice to give you a little time to recover. With that heart rate going up, you can get it back down on the leg raise and the sit up. Thank you. I'm gonna show you a set of pullover from the floor, just in case you don't want to do it on the chair. It looks like this. So it's a little bit easier, less range of motion from the floor on that pullover. Plank low row, 5 total, 3 on one side, 2 reps on the other arm. But just try and stay nice and flat on that one. Standing flexion is 5 on the right, 5 on the left. Bicep curls can be standing. Rich, I know you like curls, but keep them at 5 on the first round. You'll get more in the next round, okay? And on the dip, you're going down as low as you can, as long as it's not creating any pain on the shoulder. All right, I got that first round done in 5 minutes. That is a pretty, that's the pace actually you wanna have to be able to kind of finish it if you're at the same pace the whole time without taking too long of a break. So once you're done, maybe a sip of water and then you go right back to it. If you can finish the whole set in one sitting on 10, that's great. Typically 10 still doable. 15 and 20, that's a different ballgame. Oh yeah, it's gonna be rough, I can tell. Again, if your weights are really light, please slow down your movements, make it more challenging on yourself. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah. Get out the way. Set of 10's going good. Find it already challenging. Done with the set of 10, at least around the 13 minute mark or so. We're at 10 minutes and 30 seconds right now. And if you can get done with 15 by the 20 minute mark, you're in a good pace to finish it.
Oh yeah,
we're getting it. Woo. All right, 15, that's where it gets real. Real hard. When we get 15-20, we tend to rep it a little bit faster. and that's understandable. Scared of the shoulder presses, that's gonna be a tough one. Howdy. Finally got one set where I had to break it up. Could not finish the shoulder presses at 15. Almost halfway through our 30 minutes, guys. Pushing ourselves, keep it up, you guys. Keep that, just that pace. You already know what next, what exercise is next as you're completing your reps, so you don't waste any time.
Pull it up, 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 pull
Almost 20 minutes, guys. 19 minutes, 30 seconds in. Alright. Way to get it done. Way to work at it. We're going in the last 10. That's why I'm taking a break. Making sure I'm ready to push it for the reps of 20s, because that's going to take about 10 minutes to get that done. Maybe even a little bit more, we'll see. Here we go, last 10 minutes. Just make sure your form is still good.
I'm gonna track down the show. smile at you when you touch the floor. Hey, mama, see the hay, mama, see the hay. Trip too hard, don't shower us away. She told me to hand up, give her no escape. Bad little man, behave. Hey, let's look back, outline on it. You need me to close it, then you blow it. You want a real, roll that real. Then my shit, I won't be able to meet her. The bus is over.
Sometimes you can just gotta catch your air. Guys, 5.5 minutes. I might extend it by 2. We will see. Oh yeah, this is where you push through that pain. It's not gonna get easier, come on. Crushing it. We got 3.5 to go plus 2. I'm gonna add those two right now. 5.5. 5.5 so that we can get closer finishing it. I'm just If you're trying to get in 30, you got 2 minutes. But remember, I'm giving you 32 minutes. So if you get it done in 30, just hold a plank for 2. To move a little bit further. In the last 2 minutes. If you're done, you can hold a plank. Keep challenging yourself. Completed, so planking in my side. Time. Oh man, that was killer, right? I hope you thought so, because I'm drenched. That was intense. If you got all the way through, or if you just kept moving the whole time, awesome job. I'm gonna get us going with a stretch. Much earned, man. Feels good though. Feels good to be done with it. Put in the work. Let's do this. All right. You ready? Let's deep inhale up. Exhale in. And reach down for the floor. Just hang here, guys. is go all the way, a big breath in.
And then just fully let go.
We're walking our hands into a downward facing dog. You're gonna pedal your feet a little bit, stretch your calves, one after the other. Let's go ahead and bring the left leg next to the left hand, left foot, coming up. Hips tuck under, tailbone tucks under. You're coming forward just a little bit. And from here, you guys breathe in, right hand comes up. And exhale, reach to your left side. And from here, stay in that same position. Kick your hips back, stretch that left hamstring. Switch sides, left, right foot next to right hand. Kneeling position here. Tuck that tailbone under. Inhale, left hand comes up. Exhale, reach to your right. Far to your right. Beautiful, relax, sit your hips back. Fantastic, let's go seated position next. We're gonna put your feet together, inside of the leg stretch. While you're doing that, you guys try to squeeze your glutes and pull your knees down towards the floor to get a little bit more of a stretch inside of the legs. And sit up as straight as you can. End our stretch today on the back, and we're gonna go for a figure four stretch. So go ahead and roll over to your back, cross your right leg behind your left, and bring that left leg up. If you want to add to it, you can even stretch your left hamstring by keeping your left leg fully extended. That's up to you right here. And focus on pushing your knee, your right knee, away from you, creating more of a pull on that hip. Deep inhale, and as you exhale, switch sides. Finish up, you guys grab both knees, pull them to the outside of your body here, towards you and out. Big inhale, deep, deep inhale, as long as you can. And when you can't breathe in anymore, just let yourself extend out. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought of it. And as always, thanks for joining. Thank you for supporting me. And I will be back on Friday. Oh, and last thing, maybe we also hit upper body. So if you have extra time, stretch your upper body as well. My friend Kern Baby does a mobility flow every Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays after at 9 a.m. So if you want to join in on that, it's an Instagram live as well. You can always do that for more mobility work. Have a great rest of your day. See you on Friday.